As my Irish grandmother said, you can't have enough saints on hand to help you. And I want you to meet one of ours in an upstairs bedroom. This requires ascending the ancient elm staircase, which to me is part of the essential character of the house. So, the saint above the head of the bed is St. Martin, and he is the man who guards us, and his story, I have to say, is a really moving one. He was a 4th century Roman soldier, and outside the city walls of Amiens, he came across a beggar. The beggar was cold, so he cut his robe in half, gave the beggar half to keep him warm, and he went away with his half. And that night, he dreamt that the beggar whom he had encountered was in fact Jesus. He later converted to Christianity. He founded a monastery, became the 3rd bishop of Tours. And today, St. Martin is the most popular saint in France. So what the picture is showing us is St. Martin in the middle, handing the robe over. He's the figure very conspicuously there with his great halo. Now, the artist who created this image is something of an artistic saint himself. He's a late 13th century painter called Giotto di Bondone, one of the founding fathers of the Italian Renaissance. And he revolutionized, together with a group of others in this very early Renaissance period, the way that we see and perceive things in paintings. And if you have a look at what was going on before, you know, just a couple of generations before with Byzantine art, which was so stilted in comparison, you can see how it was a springtime in the history of painting. But for the astute amongst you, you will realize that I don't have here above my head the original Giotto. Instead, what I have is a painting that is copied by a man who in many ways was almost sort of comparably significant in art world terms in the early 20th century. And his name was Roger Fry. Now, Roger Fry was part of the Bloomsbury Group, another of those significant, intelligent, creative figures that we've touched upon a lot with paintings in this house. And he was a curator, a critic, an artist, a really formidable figure who basically changed taste for art in Britain. His 2 major seminal formidable achievements were exhibitions in 1910 and 1912, the first of which was called Manet and the Post-Impressionist painters, which was a term, post-impressionism, that he himself coined. So it just gives you an idea of how big a figure he was in art history. As befits a Bloomsbury man, he was capable of shocking and confronting, and critics were at first appalled by what they were looking at. But the paintings in those exhibitions went on to transform art in Britain and the way we perceive the concept of art. Have a look at some of these images that were in the exhibitions. So the question is, how come that the modernist ambassador in Britain, Roger Fry, should be painting a copy of a Giotto? Well, there is an answer to that, because in 1917, he organized a group of artists in the Omega Workshops, or associated with the Omega Workshops, which was a progressive design company that he founded, all to do copies of old masters, but in the process to learn things. And he himself did a copy, Fry did a copy of a Giotto. And I've got no way of knowing this, but it's quite possible that this was his entry. This was his example of learning from an old master, copying an old master, connecting the 20th century with the 13th or early 14th century. Now put the image next to the original Giotto again, and it's really very interesting to see what Fry has done, because he's slightly simplified it. He has reduced the colours, he's made the shapes stronger and more emphatic, but he hasn't lost anything. The story is still imparted in a very direct and convincing and strong way. And when you start looking into the picture, you can see aspects that show the imprint of post-impressionism. The brushstrokes in the sky, the pink rocks in the background, and those solid forms with strong outlines almost put Gauguin into your head. So what he's doing is he's looking back, he's paying homage to Giotto, but he's saying as much, perhaps in some ways more, with less. And that is one of the lessons of modernism and the avant-garde. There's a lovely quote from Virginia Woolf, a fellow Bloomsburyite, to Roger Fry, saying that in or about December 1910, human character changed. And she was referring to the exhibition that Roger Fry had, that first exhibition that so shocked people. And for me, I get quite a buzz, really, from having a little slice of that innovative moment in British culture, sitting above the bed. Next week, I'm going to go to another bedroom in the house to show you a picture that illustrates some of that post-impressionist influence that Roger Fry brought about. In the meantime, wherever you are, stay safe in this lockdown, and looking forward to returning.